In the beginning was the Word, Jesus. The Word was with God, and the Word was God. Jesus existed in the beginning with God. He gave life to everything that was created, and his life brought light to everyone. Now the light still shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it.
In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth. He blessed them and said, "Fill the earth." He made men and women in his image. He breathed his own breath into them. He blessed them and said, "Fill the earth." And the man and the woman had a good relationship with God and with each other. They were even naked, and they felt no shame.
God set the man and woman in a garden with every kind of food. In the center of the garden were two trees, the tree that gives life forever and the tree that gives the knowledge of good and evil. God said, "You can eat from anything in the garden except from the tree that gives the knowledge of good and evil. If you eat its fruit, you will die."
God looked at everything he made. "That is very good," he said. So he rested and enjoyed his good creation.
Now the snake was the shrewdest of all the animals God had made. And one day he asked of the woman, "Did God really say you can't eat any of this delicious fruit?"
"We can eat anything we want, but not from that tree in the middle of the garden. If we eat it, or even touch it, we'll die."
"You won't die. God knows that if you eat that fruit, you'll be just like him. You'll know everything."
The woman ate the fruit, and she gave it to the man who ate it. They were naked, and they were ashamed. So they covered themselves with fig leaves, and they hid from God.
God said, "It is not good for them to live like this and live forever." So God removed the man and woman from the garden, and he barred the way to the tree of life.
The man and the woman had children, and their children had children, and soon the world was full of people, just as God intended. But the world was not as God intended.
God's people came to live in the land of Egypt. They grew strong and grew in number. The Egyptians were threatened by them, so they made them their slaves. They forced them into heavy labor. God's people cried out for help.
"I have seen how the Egyptians are treating you. I have heard your cries for help. I am coming to rescue you."
God sent Moses to Pharaoh, the king of Egypt.
"This is what our God says. Let my people go."
But Pharaoh would not let them go.
God sent plague after plague upon Egypt.
But Pharaoh would not let them go.
Then God struck Egypt with one final blow.
Moses warned God's people, "Put the blood of a lamb over your doorposts. Stay inside until morning and be ready to go."
At midnight, God passed over the land of Egypt. Every firstborn son was struck dead, from the son of the lowest servant to the firstborn son of Pharaoh. A great wail arose throughout the land of Egypt, but in the camp of God's people, all was quiet. No one died. For the Lord saw the blood of the lamb and passed over their households.
"Get out," Pharaoh cried. "Take your people and go."
So Moses led the people of God out of Egypt, and God himself went ahead of them, a pillar of cloud by day and a pillar of fire by night, till they came to the promised land.
But God's people did not obey him. They followed other gods of other nations. They put their trust in kings and armies. And even though he rescued them, they chose to turn away. So they became slaves again to other nations and to their sin. Then they cried out to God, and he answered them.
"At just the right time, I will respond to you. On the day of salvation, I will help you. I will say to the prisoners, 'Come out in freedom.' And to those in darkness, 'Come into the light.' I will send a savior."
There was nothing beautiful about his appearance, nothing to attract us to him. He was despised and rejected, a man of sorrows, acquainted with grief. We turned our backs on him. We looked the other way. Yet it was our weakness he carried. It was our sorrows that weighed him down. He was beaten so we could be whole. He was whipped so we could be healed. All of us, like sheep, have strayed away. We have left God's path to follow our own, and the Lord has laid on him the sins of us all.
He came into the very world he created, but the world didn't recognize him. He came to his own people, and even they rejected him. But to all who believed him and accepted him, he gave the right to become children of God. They are reborn, not with a physical birth, but a new life that comes from God.
God showed us how much he loved us by sending his one and only Son into this world so that we might have eternal life through him. This is real love. Not that we loved God, but that he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice for our sins.
This is how God loved the world. He gave his one and only Son so that everyone who believes in him will not perish, but have eternal life.
Early on Sunday morning, before the sunrise, the women went to the tomb. And on the way, they were wondering, who will roll away the stone for us? But as they arrived, they saw the stone was already rolled away. The tomb was open, so they looked inside. They saw a young man in a white robe, an angel.
Don't be afraid. You were looking for Jesus who was crucified. He isn't here. He has risen from the dead. Now go and tell his disciples and you will see him.
Now, there is no condemnation for those who belong to Christ Jesus. And because you belong to him, the power of his Spirit has freed you from the power of sin.
For we died and were buried with Christ by baptism. And just as Christ was raised from the dead, now we also are raised to live new lives.
Thanks be to God for his unspeakable gift.
Thank you. will see a radiant beam of light dancing for a sun that warms the morning sky. Who will know the beauty of my earth, sense the joy and wonder of its birth? Who will see the glory of the world that I have made? And who will walk beside me in the garden in the coolness of the day? Creation's glorious song that comes from my heart expresses strains of love, but only in part. I long to say the one to hear my heart belongs to you. And who will feel the summer wind that moves across the water as it flows? Who will enjoy the orchestrated mystery that soars within my soul? Who will hear of the music that I hear? I will create man to be in my own image, form him from the dust of earth, and breathe into him my own breath of life. That soars within my soul. And we can feel the summer wind that moves across the water as it flows. This wondrous paradise and all that you see
that comes from my heart could never
belongs to you. My life, my love, my heart belongs to you.
Tempting his alluring smile, ever inviting.
With crafty words deceived them, to innocence believed it all, and started to fall in a myriad of lies.
Deceived him, to innocence believed it all, and started to fall.
The serpent came beguiling, so tempting his alluring smile, ever inviting. God cried, where are you, Adam? You're so afraid, please tell me.
He would deliver them from from chains of bondage. Rescue them with mighty judgments. Fulfill the promise of their fathers. Be the God of Holy Covenant.
Lord was the Spirit, Israel that came, a nation delivered as Moses had prayed. Praise to Jehovah and His mighty hand, led them from bondage to the promised land.
His very own.
He would proclaim the power of God Almighty and dwell with all the chosen people. In their midst, unveil His glory, showing them His strength in faithfulness.
The children by day, and a father.
kings of the earth and the kingdoms built by man rise up in their glory, then go back to dust again. The kings of the earth who rule with might and power will bend their knee to God when time concludes its final hour. That day will come. The kings of the earth and their power to rule the land was founded by the Lord in his covenant with man. But the kings of the earth would make their own decree that set themselves
we In fields of white, beyond the gate of dreams, there Sharon's garden lay, bathed in sun and streams. And gently nestled there, a flower so full of grace, a cherished bloom so fair, takes the breath away. The rose of Sharon, the rose of Sharon, the precious rose of Sharon. The rose of Sharon, the rose of Sharon, the precious rose of Sharon.
It grew in spring until its beauty shone, until the winter winds blew cold. This lovely bloom so sweet was taken. Each petal died. The rose of Sharon, the rose of Sharon, the precious rose of Sharon.
It was near to the heart of God. It was
so long. They had waited as a nation for a sign of liberation, knowing Messiah soon would come. So sure, if they prayed with perseverance, he would make a swift appearance, bringing the power to overcome.
The people say,
we need a Savior.
The people
pray, glory and power. Oh Lord, hear our cry.
Does he know we need him now? The people say,
send us a strong
key
to end our suffering. And the day that they would see him coming to lead their people on, reigning as a conquering avenger, watching enemies surrender and finding that liberty had come.
And rejected by man, a man who was acquainted with grief, and as one from whom men hide their faces, we regarded as one who was stricken by God. He was a man of sorrow, a man of sorrow. He was bruised by his stripes. We are healed. He bore
was God's plan to bruise him, that his soul be made an offering for sin. By the fruit of his suffering he was satisfied. This righteous servant made many righteous. O precious man of sorrows,
for he was pierced, he was bruised. By his stripes we are healed. He bore.
Yeah. to be a cross of love. Oh, Jesus, what a sacrifice to reach us. It had to be a cross.
Oh, We couldn't have this moment and not respond. Let's sing together. Crown him.
Crown him with many crowns, the Lamb upon his throne. Mark how the heavy anthem thrusts all music but its own.
Awake my soul.
Do you feel the world is broken?
We do.
Do you feel the shadows deepen?
We do.
Do you know that all the dark won't stop the light from getting through? Do you wish that you could see it all made new? Is all creation groaning?
Is
a new creation coming? Is the glory of the Lord to be the light within our midst? Is it good that we remind ourselves of this? Does the Father truly love us?
He does.
Does the Spirit move among us?
He does.
And does Jesus, our Messiah, hold forever those He loves?
He does.
And does our God intend to dwell again with us? He does, yes. Is anyone worthy?
Is anyone whole? Is anyone able to break the seal and open the scroll? The Lion of Judah, who conquered the grave, he is David's root and the Lamb who died. From the slave,
every people, from every people and tribe, every nation and tongue,
he has made us a kingdom and priests to God to reign with the Son. Is he worthy? Is he worthy of all blessing and honor and glory?
Is he worthy?
From ransomed men of tender heart, whose souls you taught to see, your children lift their voice to you with thanks for all these things. From mountain heights and golden skies, your hand is clearly seen. We cast a praise with nature's cry to God for all these things. In the night of wonder and promise, night when Christ was born, God incarnate came to be with us all, us all.
For promises from age to age that caused our hearts to dream, purest adoration we impart with thanks for all these things. For refuge from the darkening storm and rest beneath your